try it Tuesday.
I think
scary
we should
Tuesday.
Start a thing where if you get three strikes in the year, that'd be fun. If you can't do Try Tuesday, you're going to strike the third one. You have to do Mystery Box.
Oh, I like that.
Because
oh,
it's
okay.
not fair to everyone else that has to try stuff.
Right.
Or do things.
No, yeah. I don't eat meat. So you're going to strike
oysters
one.
Oysters
are
meat. Oysters are not meat.
I can't eat that. That would make me vomit immediately. I don't eat
it's called Try it Tuesday.
How would it make you vomit?
I'm
are
not
you
supposed
allergic?
To eat pig ears with hair it. On it. That's on a corn chip, but I ate it.
There was not hair on it.
There was a whisker on that pig lip,
there
honey.
There was absolutely a whisker.
There were whiskers on the pig lips.
Y'all don't know Southern delicacy like that.
I have kissed a pig and eaten its lips.
That's extra dental floss.
And I am not okay with it still.
You don't want to floss with somebody's whiskers.
Hey. All right. So Ahmad, so Ryan's going to get, is this strike 10 then, Ryan?
Strike 1.
We'll start out.
It's a new game. It's a new season.
We get three strikes for the rest of the year.
Okay. All right.
Strike
so,
one.
This is a TikTok viral delicacy that we are going to try. Ahmad, please explain.
So it is oyster Rockefeller in a can. So you basically get a tin of oysters. They're right there by where you get like your tuna, your salmon.
How much are these?
Yeah, how much they cost?
It was $2.79 for the can. That's
not bad.
That's scary. How many oysters are in there?
It looked like a lot.
That's what I'm saying.
Wait a
oysters
second. It's
cheap.
Only $2.70. So the price of a power bar is what that costs.
Yeah, pretty much.
Are they smoked oysters?
Yes, they are smoked oysters.
Okay.
And then so you sprinkle a layer of lemon juice. You put butter. You put hot sauce, Cajun seasoning, and garlic. None of the recipes I saw called for spinach, but if you could fit it in here, I say do it.
Oysters Rockefeller, if you look that up, traditionally it is like a creamed spinach type of delicacy on top of a poached oyster, and then they put breadcrumbs, maybe some bacon bits on it, Parmesan cheese, and they broil it in the oven, and it's like very delicious.
When it comes to oysters, that's the way I would eat them. I think, Kevin, you're the same, right? Oysters,
yeah,
I did raw oysters once in my life.
I've read that it's not good for you. It taste rubbery?
It's just not a fun taste.
So my thing is, if you're just swallowing it, you're not enjoying it.
No, I love raw oysters.
But that's like doing a shot. You don't even taste
oysters.
It.
No, you do taste it. I used to not taste it because I was thinking, oh, what's the point? Now I am a connoisseur of raw oysters. You got the Murder Points. You got the Gulf Coast. You got all these different oysters.
You can tell if it's East Coast because they're bigger, smaller.
The brininess of the water they came from. I definitely am an oyster person. I have never, though, wanted to even try an oyster in a can.
This kind of looks good.
I'm a fresh shucked girl. I'm not a canned girl.
Ooh, I can taste it.
Okay, so now you're going to spoon this out and put it on the Ritz dupes that you brought?
Yes, they're called croquettes.
Okay.
Wait,
so
did you pay for this with your own money?
Yes, I did.
So we're going to give you some cash.
Give him the $2.79. Come on.
No, it's more than that because you had to buy
crackers.
All the stuff, the ingredients
that
got on top.
Okay, so the cheese is a little crispy.
So you take your serving. We'll pass the plate around and take our servings, and then we'll all just do one big swoop.
Ooh.
Of the
Ahmad, thing. You're nervous.
I am nervous.
I mean, you're shaking, buddy.
I am shaking. Spoon. You make me nervous.
That could be the whiskey.
It's okay. It's going to be okay, buddy.
I want to slap the S out of you.
Okay, so tell us again, for those just tuning in, this is a can of smoked oysters, and you put what on top of it?
I put butter, Cajun seasoning,
mozzarella
cheese, hot sauce.
It went in my nose.
It smells horrible.
And yeah, that's it.
I mean, I am scared, and I do love oysters. I'm going to take a second cracker just to chase it down.
Here you go, Kevy.
All right. It is hot, which is good. You got it hot. This is all done in the microwave, so not only are they canned oysters.
Was it microwave or was it?
Air-fried.
Air-fried
at 400 for 5 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Oh, God, I can taste it.
So, here we go.
Okay, we're all ready to go. Kevin's going to be the last one.
Eric
Ahmad
just already downed his.
Wait, by the way, Ahmad, did you already try this once before? This is your first time?
Okay. This is my first time.
All right, here we go. One, two, three.
I'm not mad at it.
I don't love it, but I don't hate it.
So you're just indifferent?
It needs a little more hot sauce.
Yeah, it needs a little more flavor. A little hot sauce would be good.
Would you seek this out and eat it if you're...
If I had it in my...
Pantry
and I was desperate for something.
Hurricane food.
But then you couldn't put the air fryer on.
Oh, true.
The oysters are very...
Pungent.
Pungent, yes.
And they're kind of like velvety. Like they're kind of like... It's like velvet.
Oh, they are strong.
That's a bad dog.
Kevin, do you
the
like?
The Ritz cracker definitely
I wouldn't
is
do
necessary.
This. No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't. Mm-mm.
Yeah, would I eat this again? No, but it was nice to try. I prefer regular oyster Rockefeller. I can't do raw oysters.
But I mean, you're doing this for a whole meal for $4.
Do you feel you don't like it because of the quality or the preparation or what?
I think it's the oyster.
It's the quality of the oyster.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I get a 4 out of 10.
It's a little rubbery.
Velvet is the best way I can describe it because it's like, almost like I hate to say it, but if you've ever had like menudo or some kind of ethnic food, like in Greek it's kokoretsi. It's like you eat a heart, like a lamb heart or a kidney. The texture of the kidney is the same texture of this oyster in a can.
Ooh, that aftertaste. Yeah.
Now I need that cracker. Give me another cracker.
I chased it with another rich cracker. Now, it definitely makes a difference, Eric.
Let me ask you guys, what would regular oysters cost?
I would do that over a regular oyster.
No, like how much? Because he spent $2.79 on a can of this.
And how many oysters were in there?
No, it was just a bunch of little.
It looked like 10 of them.
The market price of an oyster is usually like $4 an oyster.
I will say on Fridays, right. Whole Foods does dollar oysters, raw oysters.
Well, how do they make it so cheap then?
On clearance.
probably. Shoot.
So if it's normally $4 for an oyster and they're packaging 10 in this little can, how
do they? Those are the ones about to go bad. They got to pop them out and smoke them real quick.
Yeah, or else they're done.
I mean, what do they do with all that leftover shrimp at the end of the night? I assume that they cook it and turn it into that steam shrimp that we get around the corner.
Do they fall off? You know, there's like certain sizes.
Yeah.
And it's like 2 weeks. It's like, this is, we never make it in the oyster world.
Oh, like because crumbs. There are different sizes, and Gulf Coast oysters are typically way bigger than the ones on the East Coast. These are very tiny oysters.
I have more of a problem with the crackers. These
these are
you don't like
Ritz.
My off-brand crackers?
They're not Ritz.
They're called croquettes.
Croquettes?
They're like a Ritz knockoff.
They're so mid.
No, but that is
not. Oh, please.
I like them.
So mid?
No, those crackers are terrible.
That's hilarious.
I'm used to Ritz, though.
Ritz was $1 so I wasn't about to do that.
Oh,
you're really cheap, though. You
got them coupons.
Yeah, I've been extremely couponing.
If you're just tuning in, Trite Tuesday was the TikTok viral oyster Rockefeller in an air fryer for a giant value of all of $4. And it was 4 out of 10.
For me.
I would say 4 out of 10.
4
out of 10,
because it wasn't like...
It's that aftertaste.
Like, really, you're the seafood connoisseur of everybody. What would you give it?
I mean, for what it is... I'm about a 3 out of 10, only because that aftertaste lingers.
Yeah,
it wasn't, it wasn't kind of like, I spit it out.
No, I've eaten way worse things.
I just wish I had more hot sauce, more flavor.
Listen, compared to pig lips on a corn chip, this is a 10 out of 10.
Yeah. It was pig lips on a Lay's chip.
Oh, whatever it was, honey.
Thank you. Yeah,
this is, I will eat 5 bites of this versus even going near that one time again.
But that's because that's so awful. But as far as it standing on its own, you've never had a Try It Tuesday in your life. This is the first thing you've eaten. What would you give it?
I need some gum. 3 out of 10. 3 out of 10.
3. Okay.
I'll give it 4, Kevin.
No, Kevin, you're not even doing a 3?
No,
we've had some bad stuff.
We've had some terrible stuff.